Hello everyone. Following up from the previous tutorial on one-to-one join by attributes, today we'll discuss the second type, the one-to-many join, where there are many rows or features for one corresponding feature geometry. We'll demonstrate these procedures using the farms classified by total farm capital table, which includes the numbers of farms reporting in six separate capital categories for each corresponding boundary. The table also requires some formatting in an external editor, including extracting the join information, which is not unusual for performing joins or integrating Statistics Canada tables with vector data presently. So within the table, we'll begin by moving the first census agricultural region name down to align with the first capital category and delete the row it was in. Then we'll copy the main table to a new workbook to continue editing. So now we must fill the census agricultural region names for each capital category. So under Find and Select, we can click Go to Special and check Blanks. In the formula bar at the top, we'll then define the cell used to fill the first blank cell and hit Control and Enter to autofill the formula down the entire column. Next, we want to extract the Census Agricultural Region unique identifiers found within the square brackets of the geography column. So to do so, we can apply this formula, which will find and extract characters within square brackets. I've included this and other helpful formulas for extracting join information within the video description. So after pasting the formula, we can use the tab in the bottom right corner of the cell to apply the formula for the entire column. Now we want to remove the char prefix, so we'll use the right formula, specifying the cell and the number of characters to take, in this case, 9. The final procedure to isolate the Census Agricultural Region unique identifiers is to take the first 4 values from the left. To extract the join information for finer census geographies, such as subdivisions, we would actually take the first 3 digits on the left and the last 4 digits on the right and concatenate them together, with the procedures otherwise being the same. Now we'll copy the extracted IDs and paste them as values in the adjacent column. We can then delete the previous 3 columns with formulas. And the final step is to provide abbreviated field names less than 10 characters in length, as we learned in the previous video. I'm adding FN in front of 2011 and 2016 to distinguish that these are farm numbers being reported within these columns. Then we'll save our table first as an Excel workbook, which we'll call Farm Cap, and then we will resave as a comma-separated values file selected from the Save As Type dropdown. Saving directly to CSV could have adversely affected our table formatting. So now we can close the program and click Don't Save. Now within QGIS, we can refresh our browser panel and load in the formatted table along with our Census Agricultural Region boundary file. Rather than using the Joins tab, which would result in a more complex workflow, we'll go to the Processing Toolbox and search Join Value, opening the Join Attributes by Field Value tool. Despite the slightly different appearance and format, the tool contains the exact same parameters as the Joins tab. We specify the 2 layers that we'd like to join, here the Census Agricultural Region's boundary file and the formatted farm capital table, and the 2 fields with common entries used to link the datasets together, in this case both being char UID. We can also specify which fields to add from our second layer. The main distinguishing feature of the tool is the ability to select the one-to-many from the join type dropdown. So, we'll now save it to a permanent file, calling it jfarmcap in our joins folder. Run the tool, and once complete, refresh the browser panel and load the layer. So we'll isolate the Census Agricultural Regions in Manitoba for a smaller area of analysis. With our selection, we can then calculate the difference in the farm numbers reporting in each capital category between the 2 census years using the field calculator. So I'll call the field dfarm1611, and expanding the fields and values dropdown, we'll subtract the number of farms in 2016 from those in 2011. So now we can apply a graduated symbology to our calculated difference field. I created a symbology file earlier for this purpose, which I'll load from file. So natural jenks was the mode to establish the ranges for visualization, and the same field was also used to label the features. It's important that we are applying the visualization to this layer, as it contains the full range of values which might not be replicated by individual capital categories. Now, within the processing toolbox, the split vector layer tool can be used to create many separate layers from a vector according to a unique ID. So if we left it as is, using the car UID, each census agricultural region would be output as a separate file. However, since we're interested in examining the changing number of farms in each capital category, we'll apply it to the farm capital class field. We'll create a new directory within our joins folder for the output files, calling it split farm capital. Ensuring it's only applied to the selected features, we can then click run. Once complete, we can now expand the directory, and for a selection of layers in the browser panel, we can right-click and select Add Layers. So with the symbology already applied to our original joined vector, we can simply right-click, copy style, and selecting all style categories. Now we can select and right-click the split layers and click Paste Style. So this enables a uniform visualization with the complete value ranges to be rapidly applied across multiple layers. I've loaded and ordered the split layers in ascending capital ranges in the prepared layers group. So now if we toggle through the separate farm capital categories, we can see a broad trend. In general, there's a decline in the numbers of farms reporting in smaller capital categories. And as we approach larger capital categories, there's a general increase in the numbers of farms reporting. This is an established trend within the agricultural sector. So joining table and vector data is a powerful tool for integrating tabulated variables in a geospatial format, facilitating analyzing and visualizing spatial and temporal variations in a wide range of reported variables. With the skills developed in this demo, users should be able to extract or match joined information from datasets, perform one-to-one and one-to-many joins between tables and vector datasets, and visualize joined variables and examine their relations with the graphics tools. Although we only joined one table to the vector datasets for each of these case uses, these procedures can be repeated to combine multiple tables and explore relations between variables at a common level. Apply these skills to datasets of interest to you. So stay tuned for the next tutorial, in which we'll cover creating maps in QGIS. And on one final note, Statistics Canada is increasingly releasing datasets in table and spatial formats on the Federal Geospatial Platform, such as median income after tax and farm operator datasets. They can be readily loaded into QGIS and used to examine trends at multiple scales. So download these datasets when available to facilitate using Statistics Canada data in QGIS.